Hello, I'm Robert Spurway, Managing Director and Chief Executive at GrainCorp, and I'm joined today by Ian Morrison, our Chief Financial Officer. Really exciting day today, Ian, announcing the results we had in financial year 21. And it was an exceptional year for GrainCorp. EBITDA of $331 million, up from $108 million the prior year, and net profit after tax of $139 million, up from a small loss the prior year. Both of those numbers at the top end of our earnings guidance announced in August. Importantly, Ian, our return on invested capital lifted to 11.1%. So we're doing what we said we would through the strategy, focusing on the core of the business and lifting returns. Can you talk us through the strength across all the segments and the drivers behind the results we're announcing today?
Oh, thanks, Robert. I'd be delighted to talk to some of those drivers. Starting out with agribusiness, this year's record East Coast Australian winter crop allowed us to receive 16.5 million tonnes of grain, and that's up from just over 4 million tonnes in the prior year. Our supply chain really comes into its own in an export year, and this year we were delighted to export nearly 8 million tonnes compared to 1.3 million tonnes in the prior year. It wasn't all about the East Coast crop though. Our processing segment also had a great year. Our crushing operations saw an 8% uplift in total crush volumes, and our foods business also onboarded a new flagship customer, seeing it deliver a strong result also.
So really some exceptional performance right across the supply chain and a team effort making the most of the opportunities that were there. I really do want to thank everyone in GrainCorp for that team effort and their contribution to the result in this last year. Ian, we also finished the year in a really strong position on the balance sheet. Just talk us through that briefly.
Yeah, our core debt finished at $1 million, and that compares to $37 million from the prior year, so really demonstrating that strength of our balance sheet.
So off the back of those results, the board today has declared a final dividend of 10 cents per share, fully franked. That takes our total dividends for financial year 21 to 18 cents per share, fully franked. Additionally, today GrainCorp's announced an on-market share buyback of up to $50 million commencing in February. So we are really delivering on what we said in terms of providing returns to shareholders and continuing to invest in our business and the strategy. Ian, the other announcement that we made today was the relaunch of our sustainability report. It's at the heart of our vision and purpose, and really great to be able to celebrate some of the things we're doing well. But importantly, we've laid out the commitments over the next 12 months and beyond in terms of what we'll do, not just to deliver on our commitment for net zero by 2050, but to accelerate that and really set some clear targets over the next 12 months and deliver on those. Finally, Ian, in terms of outlook, we're into harvest now. What's it looking like?
Yeah, looking ahead to this year's harvest, again, it's looking like a really strong crop right across the East Coast. We're working hard to ensure we can receive that crop safely and support growers to do it in an efficient manner.
And indeed, in that respect, we've invested in another million tonnes of storage to be ready for that large crop. It is a really busy time, not just for all of us at GrainCorp, but all of our growers in the middle of that harvest. We wish you all the very best for a safe and prosperous harvest and another great year ahead. Thank you for joining us, everyone.